this lecture, we will see some basic properties of N-type semiconductor. So we know that in pure semiconductors, the carrier concentration of both electrons and holes at normal temperature is very low, and hence for getting a sufficient amount of current, of electric current, through the semiconductor, the applied electric field must be very large. But concentration or concentration of carriers or conductivity of semiconductor could be increased by adding some impurity atoms in the semiconductor lattice. The impurity added are called dopants. We all of us know of it that for intrinsic semiconductor we can get only limited amount of current, but by adding some dopants we can increase their conductivity and the impurities that we are going to add are or is known as dopants. And due to dopants, available energy states are altered and in this way one or more energy levels may appear. in the band structure. Our main objective is to increase these available energy states. And some dopants frequently used for germanium and silicon are the elements of group 3 and 5 of the periodic table. So I am not going deep in what we call these semiconductor when we add group 3 or group 5 elements, because all of you know about this, I'm sure. So first, let me explain some basic properties of n-type semiconductor. So here I am using an example of silicon, and we know that F is valency of silicon is 4, and here I am introducing phosphorus atom as donor or as impurity. And what is going here, I am going to explain using some bullet points or some number. So first, please note these points. When a pentavalent atom of group 5 such as phosphorus arsenic or antimony is introduced, into silicon, then it is known as n-type semiconductor. And I'm sure all of you know this. And second point is, we can see all these points in this diagram. That is, phosphorus has 5 atoms in its conduction band, or its valency is 5. So I'm going to explain about this image in the following points. So now second point is, out of five valence electrons of phosphorus it make out of five valence electrons of impurity atom make covalent bonds with four silicon atoms while the fifth valence electron remains loosely bound to its nucleus. That is the nucleus of phosphorus atom. Third point is very small energy is needed to detach this fifth electron from its nucleus and make it free to conduct. Number four, the energy level corresponding to the fifth valence electron lies in the band gap of the silicon and just below the conduction band of silicon. This level is called as donor level. We can make a graph of it that when we add a pentavalent impurity, the fifth electron that is loosely bound to its parent, we know that this is the band gap of the silicon. So now this fifth electron has energy level which is just below the conduction band of the silicon. And this level is known as donor level. Now next point, I think it's fifth. Depth of donor level below the conduction band is merely about 0.01 electron volt for germanium and 0.03 electron volt for silicon, and these points should be noted. We can also make a formula that relates this donor level, but here we don't need it. So sixth point is since each pentavalent atom donate one free electron for conduction, such type of impurity or such type of impurities are known as donor or n-type impurities. Next to the point is in n-type semiconductor, current is mainly carried by electrons and called majority carriers. While thermally generated holes are known as minority carriers. In n-type semiconductor, because current is only due to electrons, so here we can call electrons as majority carriers and holes as minority carriers. And a very important point is that as I said in last lecture, they also obey the law of mass action, that is NP equal to NIPI, or we can write it NI square. That is the product of number of electrons and holes are always remain constant. So now it's time to know the carrier concentration in n-type semiconductor. So now what is carrier concentration? In n-type semiconductor, let's make some Venn diagram. This is conduction band. And this is valence band. And we know that there is a donor level that I am representing it by ED. And we also know that for a pure semiconductor, there is a Fermi level which is always at its middle, so I am calling it as intrinsic Fermi level. But here, since we are doping with electrons, so here the Fermi level, let me take this here, is between the energy level of conduction band and ED. So this is the Fermi level for n-type semiconductor. So again, let's write some main points. So first, at 0 Kelvin, we know that all the donors are in the unionized state, that is all the donor levels are occupied with electrons. But as the temperature increases, slightly some of get ionized. And contribute to the conduction band. At the same time, some of the valence band electrons may jump to the conduction band. Leaving behind holes in the valence band. However, number of holes produces in this process is quite low or small, and next to the point is, that is point number 3. Fermi level lies near the middle of the donor level and the bottom of the conduction band, as I said earlier. And number 4, number of electrons is equal to the sum of ionized donors ND in donor level and the concentration of thermal generated holes in the valence band. That is that is number of electrons, that is N, which is equal to the number of donor atoms that ionized plus number of holes that created due to thermal energy. And in earlier expression we know that what is this number. We used a formula for getting the electron concentration in intrinsic semiconductor, and that is the n equal to nc exponential minus ec minus ef by kt. We will use this formula later. But here, since nd plus is very very larger than p, so we can use n equal to or nearly equal to nd plus. Nd plus are the number of ionized atoms, and please note that nd, this nd is the total number of impurity atoms that we added in the semiconductor, and nd plus are the atoms out of this nd that are ionized. And from mass action formula, we can also write that P is equal to ni square by nd plus. Since np equal to ni square, and here n is equal to nd plus, so we put that here and we simply write this formula using mass action formula. So these formulas will be very helpful in solving some numerical problems in NAT or GATE. So now we can get concentration of ionized donors. Since n equal to nearly equal to the number of ionized donors, so by knowing that concentration, we can simply get the concentration of electrons. And by using the same formula that I used earlier for getting n and p, I am using this same technique, first using density of state and another formula, and by using Fermi distribution function I can get this formula as nd plus, which is equal to nd exponential minus ef minus ed by kt. By using the same method that I have used earlier for getting n or p, but here this is the only difference. In that formula for n or p, for n there is nc and for p there is np, but here I am replacing that nc or np by nd, and we know this number because we know the number of atoms, impurity atoms that we are going to add. So, and as I wrote earlier, we know that n equal to nc exponential minus ec minus ef by kt. And from earlier equation, we know that for n-type semiconductor, n equal to nd plus. So from here, let me write it as 1 and it 2. From here, we can equate these two equations 1 and 2. So from here, we can write n c exponential minus e c minus e f by k t, which is equal to n d exponential minus e f minus e d by k t. Let's say this is equation number 3. So we can solve this equation by equating, and from here we can write EF, which is equal to ED plus EC by 2 plus KT by 2 log natural ND by NC. Here I am writing a direct solution of this equation by making this for EF and taking logarithm on both sides, we can get this. So if we see this equation, we can estimate the Fermi level for n-type semiconductor, which is nearly equal to, which is nearly in between ED and EC. But here one thing is important, that we know that NC directly proportional to T raised to the power 3 by 2. So this is directly proportional to T raised to the power 3 by 2. So this equation is not valid for T equal to 0 Kelvin and T equal to infinity. So when we put here T equal to 0, then we can get it's as infinity, and when we get T equal to infinity, then this is also not valid. So this equation is not valid for 0 Kelvin and in temperature, infinite temperature. And let me check, it's what is the number of the 4. And the fifth point is, because at very high temperature the assumption of suppressing the holes does not hold good. We know that at t is equal to 0, this function will blow up, but when we use higher temperature, then holes are also going to be increased. So we can't neglect those holes. So at these two extreme cases, we can't apply this equation. But for sufficiently large temperature, it drops 2 is e by 2, that is, here I am talking about EF, that is coincides the intrinsic level, that is I denoted as EI, that is as T increases, the Fermi level moves downward and crosses the donor levels. This point number 6 is very important, and you should understand this point. And as I wrote earlier, we know that n equal to nc exponential minus ef minus ei by kt on putting this value in equation number, I think it's 3, equation number, yes it's 3, number 3, we can get n equal to nc exponential ed minus ec by 2kt plus half log natural nd by nc, which is again equal to nc nd by nc half exponential ed minus ec by 2kt. And finally we can get a number n, that is nd nc half exponential ed minus ec by 2kt. So this is the carrier concentration in n-type semiconductor, or this is the number of electrons that are present in n-type semiconductor at temperature T with doping level ED, conduction minimum conduction band level at EC, and with number of dopants that is equal to ND. And we can again write it as N equal to ND NC half into exponential minus delta E by 2 kT. And what is delta E? Delta is equal to EC minus ED. So this is the number of electrons present in n-type semiconductor. And we know that conductivity, which is equal to Ne mu n, mu n is the mobility. We can write it as E, and we know what is n. N is equal to almost equal to Nd plus mu n. So this is the value of conductivity for n type semiconductor. That is, we have to replace this n with Nd plus number. But here we have to note some, and as I calculated earlier, that is by putting the value of this Nd plus in this equation and making this mu n, that is mobility, temperature independent, we can make a graph between conductivity and temperature. And I am not going to explain that equation. You can try that equation, that you have to put the number Nd plus or n that I calculated in this lecture, and by using logarithmic scale on both sides, you can make a relation between conductivity and this temperature. And by following that equation, you can get a graph that looks like this between 1 by T and log natural of conductivity. So we know that in an intrinsic semiconductor, this is like that graph looks like this, or that is a straight line, but here we can't get a straight line. So normally this looks like this. If I mark this as A point, this is at point B, this C, and this point D. So you must know that as I increase the temperature, or because this scale is 1 by T, so we are increasing the temperature in this direction. So please note some points here. And these points are very important. To understand the electrical conductivity in n-type semiconductor or also in p-type. So first, at low temperature, about 10 K, that is corresponding to the point A, the conductivity increases with rise in temperature. This is due to the increase in the number of conduction electrons as a result of ionization of the donors. And second point, the conductivity attains a maximum value corresponding to point B. When all the donors are ionized, the temperature corresponding to this is about 50 K for a moderately N-type germanium. And next to the point is the conductivity decreases with further increase in temperature. To about room temperature, that corresponding to point C and is attributed to the decrease in the value of mobility with rise in temperature. There is also an increase in the intrinsic conductivity but to a lesser extent. And next to the point is point 4, that is the sharp rise in conductivity. From C to D is due to the large increase in intrinsic conductivity. Which offsets the decrease in mobility. So this is all about the N-type semiconductor, and there are many points that you have to understand. That is why a sharp increase in conductivity from C to D, and another thing, and why I am using this point, intrinsic conductivity, although I am here using N-type semiconductor or extrinsic semiconductor. So in next lecture we will see the basic electrical properties of P-type semiconductor.